Good morning everyone, I'm Maëlle Sergol and I am going to present you my work about structural composite laminate materials with low dielectric loss. We will approach these topics through theoretical model and dielectric characterizations. I will first present the context and the purposes of this work. Then I will introduce the characterization devices that we used and the materials that we studied. After presenting the dielectric study, I will end with a discussion and a conclusion. This work is a part of a collaborative project named STARCOM. In English, that means Breakthroughs, Antennas, Systems and Technologies in Composite Materials. The two main purposes of the STARCOM project are the functionalization of structural panels made of composite materials through the antenna embedding and the miniaturization of antennas and integration devices. By diversifying the operating frequency bands, the consortium aims to open new applications and new markets. For this work, we were interested in the multifunctional materials for radio frequency communications. More specifically, we work on the antenna implementation into load-bearing composite panels. Some open literature studies have already worked on this kind of topic. For example, Kim et al. Developed a multiband aerovehicle smart skin antenna operating at 300 MHz. They used a radiating element made of plastic and copper stacked between two structural composite face sheets made of glass fibers. At higher frequencies, Manak et al. Developed a pure composite laminate antenna. By inserting a patch of carbon fibers into a laminate made of glass fibers and polyester resin, they obtained an antenna working as well as a copper one from 600 MHz to 2.1 GHz. Another embedded antenna technology consists of integrating the different elements of the antenna into the layers of a composite sandwich. Yu et al. Did this between layers of honeycomb to develop an antenna operating at 12.2 GHz. However, when we look at the fibers reinforced dielectric laminates classically used for antenna applications, we notice that these are mainly made of E-glass or S-glass fibers associated with polyester, vinyl ester or epoxy thermosetting resins. We note that these materials highlight relative permittivity around 4 and loss dielectric tangent always higher than 0.01. These values are given between 1 and 75 GHz and could be relatively high for electromagnetic wave transparency. For the present work, we just focused on organic matrix composite materials. These materials are known for their lightness, their mechanical resistance, their insensitivity to corrosion, and their ability to embed new applications. From different couples of reinforcement and matrix, we theoretically and experimentally study the dielectric characteristics in order to highlight the best load-bearing composite laminate for antenna substrate and radome applications. To measure the dielectric characteristics of our composite laminates, we use two different devices. The first one is the impedance measurement. By a local measurement, this device provides information from 100 MHz to 1 GHz. At higher frequencies, we used a free space measurement device. By using the reflection and the transmission of the electromagnetic wave, we obtain information from 18 to 26 GHz. These two devices allow to retrieve the complex dielectric permittivity from which we deduce the relative permittivity epsilon r and the dielectric loss tangent delta. Regarding the materials studied here, we have three types of fibers, the quartz fibers, the S2 glass fibers, and the E-glass fibers. Because these reinforcements are fibers, we were not able to characterize them by impedance measurement. We thus retrieve the dielectric characteristics from literature. These three types of fibers highlight relative permittivity epsilon f from 3.7 to 6.4 at 1 GHz. Regarding the dielectric loss tangent delta f, we have values from 0.0001 to 0.0031. To make a composite laminate, we have to associate these fibers with thermosetting resins. We have thus selected three natures of resin, the urethane acrylate, the polyester, and the epoxy resin. We have then casted these resins into silicon molds and we measured the dielectric characteristics by impedance measurements, as presented previously. At 1 GHz, these resins highlight relative permittivity, epsilon m, from 2.6 to 3.1, and dielectric loss, tangent delta m, from 0.005 to 0.025. Only with this data, we can see that the quad fibers and the urethane acrylatresin presents the most interesting dielectric characteristics for the targeted applications. This gives a first overview of what will follow. To associate these fibers with these resins, we implement the classic vacuum infusion process. During the fabrication, dry fabrics were stacked onto a wax glass slab and placed under vacuum. Fabrics were thus infused jointly with the liquid thermosetting resin. After polymerization, we obtained 9 separate composite laminates that you can see in this table. We retrieved the fiber volume fraction from the number of plies, the mass of fibers, the fiber density, and the plate thickness. This parameter will be necessary for the theoretical study of the dielectric characteristics that we will see on the next slide. Before proceeding to measurements, we wanted to estimate the dielectric characteristics of the laminates by theoretical calculations. We thus studied various mixing rules as the Maxwell-Garnett law. This three-dimensional model considers spherical inclusions inserted into a host medium to compute the effective permittivity of the composite media. This effective permittivity can be represented as the macroscopic relative permittivity of the composite. However, these models consider the composite media as lossless materials. In our case, we wanted to compute the dielectric loss of four materials. We thus used the Sivola's works to compute the complex dielectric permittivity of composite from the Maxwell-Garnett rule. As Ball and Cotari did, we then considered the fibers as two-dimensional cylinder dielectric inclusions embedded into a dielectric matrix. We finally assumed that the 2D Maxwell-Garnett mixing rule can compute the complex permittivity of our composite laminate, epsilon asterisk comp, from the complex permittivity of the resin, epsilon asterisk m, the complex permittivity of the fibers, epsilon asterisk f, and from the fiber volume fraction. This thinking is suitable for frequencies lower than 3 GHz. At higher frequency, the wavelength of the electromagnetic field is not large enough in comparison with the dispersion and dimensions of the fiber used. To compare the theoretical values computed from the adapted 2D Maxwell-Garnett rule, we implemented impedance measurements from 100 MHz to 1 GHz. The results show that the relative permittivity of the composite laminate is controlled by the nature of reinforcement. You can see on the left graph that the highest values of relative permittivity are obtained with laminates made of e-glass fibers. On the contrary, laminate made of glass fibers present the lowest relative permittivity. Regarding the dielectric loss, results are mainly controlled by the nature of the resin. So, we see that the laminates infused with epoxy resin have the highest dielectric loss, while the laminates made of urethane acrylate and quartz fibers presents the lowest values, which is 0.0031 at 1 GHz. To complete these results, we made free space measurements from 18 to 26 GHz. On these graphs, we observed the same trends. The quartz urethane acrylate laminate is always the materials with the lowest relative permittivity and the lowest dielectric loss. We can now compare the theoretical values with the experimental results. With these two examples, we see a good fit between theoretical and measured values. We thus obtain fair dielectric characteristics of our composite laminate materials from the 2D Maxwell-Garnett model. We can now retain the quartz urethane acrylate laminate, which presents relative permittivity of 3.1 and dielectric loss around 0.003 from 100 MHz to 1 GHz. At higher frequencies, the dielectric loss increased to 0.0065. This laminate is thus the most attractive one for microwave applications. In the literature, we find the quartz cyanotester laminate, which is presented as the combination providing the lowest loss achievable from commercial off-the-shelf aerospace materials. At 300 MHz, this laminate has higher dielectric loss than the quartz urethane acrylate laminate. Despite the fact that quartz cyanotester presents dielectric loss of 0.003 at 10 GHz, this nature of resins involves complex fabrications and high costs. From these discussions, we highlight the high relevance of quartz urethane acrylate laminate for low-loss load-bearing composite panel applications at microwave. To conclude, I presented the theoretical and experimental studies that we conduct on dielectric composite laminates at microwave. From the 2D Maxwell Garnett mixing rule, we obtained a fair theoretical dielectric characteristics. By comparison with impedance measurement results, we obtained a good fit. After showing the dielectric performance of the quartz urethane acrylate laminate, we can conclude that urethane acrylate is a promising thermosetting resin for substrates and radomes of antennas embedded into load-bearing composite panels. If you want more details about this work, please feel free to consult the article published in Composites Part C. Thank you for your attention.